Good afternoon, everyone. We have the pleasure of presenting the University Music Day under the theme, Excellence in Music Ministry. I want to say that we, from the Department of Music and Fine Arts, we appreciate the fact that Dr. Marilyn Flinch invited us to be in charge of this day. And indeed, we have grasped the opportunity to showcase the talents that God has given us. We know that this particular period within the context of the university schedule that is always on Mondays is that it is devoted to worship. It's that worship chapel. So in other words, what we are doing here is that we're wanting to present in the first half of the program the matter of worship to God. And so this is how we are going to lead the event in terms of starting with God. We want to say here that the Lord has given all of us talents, and talents that we can use not only for worship, but also for entertainment and otherwise. So this is what you are going to experience this afternoon, in that we are going to have that display of talents, the range of talents that's going to be here from the music department. So without further ado, I just want to say again, welcome to you all, and we will now proceed with our program as scheduled. At this point, the first part of the program, first section of the program, will take into consideration the choral rendition that is going to be presented by the NCU choral group, and that is not live, but is videoed, and you will have, we'll have that as our opening hymn. And then we're going to have our scripture reading by Mr. Erlen Cornwall, who is our faculty in the Department of Music, and he'll also offer the prayer. And then we will have a vocal solo, which is going to be a video that will present Miss Glenda Anderson, who is our voice teacher in the Department of Music. And then after that, we will have a brief presentation by Dr. Diana Sinclair, who will present the matter of this focus that we have here today that is so important. And I thank you. Thank you.
Good afternoon. Our scripture reading is taken from Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is good. He is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Let us pray. Dear most kind, loving, eternal Father, we thank you for the wonderful blessings you have given us for another day. We thank you for the gift of music. And as we are here today to celebrate, we ask that you will continue to lead us, continue to direct us. Be with this program. Help that it will go to the blessing of each heart that listens. Continue to lead us and direct us, I pray. Amen.
Join in. God made us, so let us be thankful. We didn't come about by chance. We didn't make ourselves, so let us praise him. Let us praise him with our various talents and abilities. Let us be thankful. Let us bless his name. We are all made in the image of God. God the Creator. For some people, it's a big stretch to accept that we are all indeed creative beings. Think of any child that you have observed. They love to play, to imagine, to create. But as we grow older, some of us allow our minds to be caged, to be limited, and then we decide that we're not good at art, or we don't like music, or we're just not creative. Being made in the image of God means that we all have the ability to create in some way, shape, or form. More recently in human history, we've been introduced to the concept of multiple intelligences, Howard Gardner's 1983 theory of multiple intelligences. This speaks to the ever-widening grasp of the differences and the similarities between us as humans. I would suggest that any discipline, no matter how remote or how far removed from what we call fine art, can still involve creativity. I'm talking about the fact that when God created the world, he said it was good, very good. He said that it was beautiful and that at the end of the week, he rested from the work that he had done. Having a talent, a hobby, a course of study, an ability to imagine or to create something is a God-given gift. We are all made in the image of God. We are all creative in some way. Please do work and pray to discover your creativity if you haven't already. We have a responsibility to work at developing our abilities, our talents, our gifts, putting in the effort to make whatever it is suitable and available for the Holy Spirit to reach out to others. Those participating in today's program have put in the effort. They have been working to develop, and they have something that they would like to share with us. We work hand in hand with God. I hope you find that awe-inspiring. We work hand in hand with God to communicate with people and to save souls. So, as you listen today, I'd like you to open your mind. Open yourself to the music that will be shared. Consider for yourself how you are created, how you are creative. There are so many ways. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10 says, "For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God. Not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus, unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them." So, let us continue to encourage each other to work at our chosen study, to prayerfully develop our gifts for use in God's service. We're going to begin today with Hansara Johnson. She's a pianist, and she will be playing the Sarabande from Johann Sebastian Bach. Thank you. That was Miss Hansara Johnson playing the Sarabande on the piano. The Sarabande is by Johann Sebastian Bach, and Hansara is one of our music majors. Keep your ears peeled. She'll be having her senior piano recital sometime soon. Our next item is Mr. Ernwell Cornwall. He's one of our faculty members, and he's going to be playing the clarinet. He's accompanied by one of the adjunct instructors, Mr. Stephen Shawnar, and they'll be playing Adoration. Thank you. That was Adoration, Mr. Erlon Cornwall on the clarinet, accompanied by Stephen Shawnar on the piano, two of our faculty members. The clarinet is one of those instruments that has such a distinctive sound. It's a single reed instrument, and those students of music appreciation will also recognize that it's from the woodwind family and the aerophone classification. Our next item is Roneil Williams, a pianist. He's also a music major, and he's going to be playing a well-known piece by Claude Debussy. I hope that you'll find it familiar and beautiful. Clair de Lune. Thank you. Claire de Lune by Claude Debussy. Thank you, Ranil. Next, we have another pianist, another music major, this time André Green. André is going to be playing a Beethoven sonata. This is Sonata Number 6, Opus 10, Number 2. And André is going to be playing the first movement of this Beethoven sonata.
Thank you.
Thank you, Andre. That was Beethoven's Sonata, number 6, opus 10. Next, we have a change. We have one of our young violinists. For those who are not aware, we have community music school students. Age is no limitation, so anyone who's interested in playing the violin or any instrument can contact us. Rahid is accompanied by his teacher, Miss Broomfield, and he's going to be playing Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, Suzuki Variation. Thank you. Thank you. That was the Suzuki variation of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star by Raheed McCullough on the violin. Next, we have another Commuting to Music School student on the piano this time. Bruce Chambers is going to play Little Sonata Moderato by C.H. Wilton. Thank you. That was Bruce Chambers. Next, we switch back to a music major, and we have now the trumpet. Mr. Odain Solomon is going to be playing the trumpet sonata, Opus 18, just the first movement. This is by Thorvald Hansen, and he'll be accompanied by the collaborative pianist, Mr. Stephen Shawnar. The trumpet, as you know, is a brass instrument, and it is one of the aerophone classifications, the brasswind family. Please give your attention to Mr. Odain Solomon. Thank you. Thank you. That was Odane Solomon on the trumpet. Next, we have another music major, this time a singer. We have Wade Arorola, and he's going to be singing for us. Maybe you'll be able to tell what type of voice he has. And the title of the piece is Lunghi Dal Caro Bene by Giuseppe Sarti. He's accompanied by Mr. Shona, our collaborative pianist. Please give your attention to Wade Arorola. Thank you, Edero. That was an Italian love song. And if you didn't quite catch it, Edero has a baritone voice. You could hear those beautiful high notes and the low notes. Next, we have guitar. Cameron Houghton is one of our music majors. He's a guitarist. And he's going to be playing for us Snow Flight by Andrew York. As you know, the guitar is a chordophone instrument. It has six strings, and I think if you listen carefully, you'll be able to hear the high pitches and the low pitches. Give your attention to Cameron Houghton, please.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Cameron. That was Snowflight by Andrew York, and Cameron Houghton played the guitar. Next, we have a community music school student, Miss Amelia Garcia. Amelia's going to be playing the piano, a well-known piece by Johann Sebastian Bach, The Prelude in C Major. Thank you, Amelia. That was Amelia Garcia playing The Prelude in C Major by Johann Sebastian Bach. Now we have another music major. This time, a third-year student, Najee Berthright. He's also preparing for his senior recital. And he's going to be playing a piece by Oswald Russell. It's called Jamaica Dance, Number 2. Thank you, Najee. That was Jamaican Dance by Oswald Russell. We hope that you've enjoyed the time with us this afternoon. We've come to the last item, and this time we're going to have an ensemble. This is the NCU Instrumental Ensemble. They're going to be playing a well-known melody. It's arranged by Longstaff, and the title of the melody is Take Time to Be Holy. Sorry, there's been a change. They're going to be playing The Holy City. Please give your attention to the NCU Instrumental Ensemble led by Mr. Erlon Cornwell. Thank you. That was the NCU Instrumental Ensemble playing an arrangement of The Holy City. Now we just have our closing remarks and our closing prayer to finish. We have Dr. Vincent Peterkin, the Dean of the College.
I'm sure that everyone here can say that this was really a wonderful program. Thank you. And that God manifested his blessings in that the talents that you saw here and you heard, they were the talents that he has given to each one who performed this afternoon. And I just want to say thank you to our communications team, who really have done a marvelous job. And of course, to our host, Dr. Diana Wilson, who actually steered the whole matter of the presentations throughout this evening. And of course, I can't forget our teachers, the teachers who have actually shaped all of these students that you've heard this afternoon. And without them and their ability to really train these talents, I mean, it's just remarkable. So we want to say thanks to those teachers that we have there in the music department. And I want to just remind you that the music department is a department with three accredited degrees. One in the Bachelor of BMUS in music, the BMUS in music education, and the bachelor's in piano performance and pedagogy. So we are wanting those who are interested in pursuing the music career to think of Northern Caribbean University Department of Music and Fine Arts. So we want to extend to you blessings for the rest of the week, and may God bless you real well. And at this time, Dr. Vincent Peterkin will close with prayer. Thank you.
Will you bow our heads with me as we pray? Loving Lord, we want to thank you for the feast we have had in music. We thank you for gifting your people and giving us the Department of Music and Fine Arts that we could put on this wonderful expression today. We pray that you'll continue to bless the leadership, bless all our students, our faculty and staff in that great department. And we pray, Lord, that you'll continue to help, that they will impact lives for the better. To this end, we want to recommit everyone into your loving arms and care, and thank you again for your gracious presence throughout this festive moment. Grant us all your peace as we separate one from the other. Do bless all those who put hands and heart together so that this could have been a success. To you be the honor, the praise, and the glory. And thank you so much for hearing and answering our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.